channel Romanica, and I'm back to another 365 days of samples. I have all the samples that I used since the last update in this tray, and if you ask my FabFitFun, probably you saw, and I saw that many of you who have the FabFitFun box picked up this tray. I really, really like it and fits perfect my products for the project pens. Anyway, let's see what I used as I finished as samples from the 365 days of samples. We're going to talk about those products and then we're going to move and pick up new items. There is one single item, a hair product, that I didn't use because it's quite a big deluxe sample, let's say big, because I use something else and I usually don't mix products. But we'll talk about that item when the time comes. Also, I have some makeup products that I'm not counting as finished because probably I will never finish them, who knows. But anyway, let's start digging in this basket, and probably I will go by my list so I can tell you some details about them. So I have a couple samples, as I told you in the last update, samples that I used last year, but because the last update had enough products, I didn't have all of them in there, so I will tell you about them here. I'll only a couple samples from Mary Kay, and also the total number of products of samples that I finished are 47. So let's see the first item. The first one is the Mary Kay Time Wise Day Solution, and this one I believe was I have several samples, and let's see which one was. This one is the night one, and I think it's this one, anti-fading moisturizer. Was okay as far as I remember regarding those products, because I used them a while ago. There was a sample that I really liked, that was one that I didn't like at all. The other ones were just okay. One of or two products are discontinued, and I will tell you which one are those. Also, I will leave on the screen the price for the products, and also considering that some of them are not available on the website, on the brand website, they are available on other websites including Amazon. I will leave the price that I will find online. That doesn't mean it's the real price for the product, the one that the brand was using when they sell the product, because some of them are quite expensive for what they are. But whatever who sells on Amazon are just whatever, not gonna comment about that, but they are using prices like I would never pay. But anyway, let's see about this one. And this one is listed as $51, still available for sale. Do I recommend it? I didn't use enough those samples, and keep in mind that this is more like a first impression for some of them. I will mention the ones that I used before, and I will tell you if I will buy them or not. This one, definitely, it's not one of them. Then the next one in here, it's Mary Kay Time Wise Night Solution, and I loved this one. I remember liking this one a lot. And it's this sample right here. And also I saw it's a serum, a night eye serum. About this one, it's of course it's discontinued, but you still can find it on Amazon, with vitamin antioxidants and collagen. I really, really like this one. I found it effective when I use it. Still available. I don't know about the expiration date for the products that are discontinued, and but still available. I cannot guarantee if it's okay to buy them or not. The third one was Mary Kay Time Wise 3-in-1 Cleanser, and this one was just okay. It's for oily skin and sensitive skin. Was just fine. Then was the Mary Kay Time Wise Age Fighting Moisturizer, and I think I just show you then. The first one that I told you was the sunscreen, and was this one. I showed you a wrong product. The first one was this one, and this was the product that I didn't like at all. So the day one is this one, and I showed you the night one. This one is the day one. This one was the night serum. And about the cleanser, as I told you, it's for oily skin, was just fine. Then I have the Mary Kay's Wise Age Fighting Moisturizer. And I think this one was the oil and fragrance free for sensitive skin to reduce wrinkles and fine lines. And I'm a little bit confused about them because I had so many. Let's go over them again. This one is the sunscreen, the night solution. And the night solution will be the single one that I would buy. Then we have the 3-in-1 cleanser, which is this one. And this is the fourth one, the age-fighting moisturizer. So this one was just okay. And we have one more, the balancing moisturizer formula 2. Another one that was just fine for normal and combination skin, which is also discontinued. So that's all about Mary Kay. I have probably one more sample like this in my bathroom, which is a mask, if I remember right. We'll talk about that one probably in another review. I am not so much into Mary Kay products. I tried more makeup products from them than skincare, but so far there was one product that I liked. Then we had the XO Pore Remover Acetone Free, and this one is acetone free nail polish remover made with organic ingredients. Great products, work so well, removes nail polish in no time. You can use one of these for one hand. It's with organic natural ingredients, comes in lavender, mint and orange, and also the unscented one. This one was the unscented one. And about this one, they are quite expensive. 10 wipes like this are $8.99, 24 almost $18. I will leave all the prices on the screen. I really like them. I'm using more wipes now than the liquid acetone or nail polish remover. I would like to buy this one. If I will find this one in a sale, I will definitely buy. Right now I'm using another product, and let's talk about this one if I have it here. Is the gel polish remover wraps from Le Mini Macaron. You can find this one on Ulta website, and you can get them with a great discount when Ulta have sales. And also this one comes with 100 wipes, works very well too. You can use this one for gel polish or for regular nail polish. I didn't use it yet for gel, but I will let you know in empties how it works for gel polish. For nail polish, works wonderful. So if you use this kind of product, this is one that I do recommend. Then we have the Garnier Skin Active, and this one is the Moisture Bomb, whatever, it's an old product. Let's see where is that one hiding. Is this one very well-known product, loved by many, including me. I like the texture. About this one, it's a water-like gel cream with hyaluronic acid, goji berry, vitamin C and E, and pomegranate. To use it twice a day for face and neck. Nice for to add hydration to your skin. I use many of this, like this one before. I have somewhere the full size, and so far Garnier, it's a brand that I like to buy more on the affordable side. So I like this one, I will use it again. Then we have the Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Gel, and is this one. It's a product that doesn't work for everybody. For as I heard, for many, this one goes with is followed by a lot of breakouts. Not for me, it worked well for me. This one is best for dry skin. Although I have oily skin, I had no problem. It's for face and neck, to use twice a day with sunflower seed, barley extract, cucumber fruit extract and hyaluronic acid. I do like it. If I have samples, I will use it again. I like how silky my skin felt after I used this one. As far as I have samples, I'm not gonna buy the full size. Then I have the Mary Kay Signature was a sample lipstick in apricot glaze. And let's take some of them out so I can find the tiny one. It was that one, and I really enjoy, I like the color for this one. If I wouldn't have so many, and this one is still available. Excuse me, it's still available. It's available on Amazon, of course, and the price is almost $28. But I enjoy the formula and the color. So one more sample out of my collection. Then we had another Mary Kay product, and that one was an eyeshadow, which I also really liked. I used from these samples probably 3 times. Is the Cinnabar. Very nice formula. It blends so nice and well. I have one more sample in a different shade that I will use, but so far I like this one. I use it when I was using one color, which is usually my everyday makeup, and I like the formula. If you're looking for something affordable, the full size comes in singles. The full size, it's $8. Then we have some sunscreens, and I have quite a bunch of them, and I will start with the MD Solar Science, and I think I have 2 of them. So I use two of those. I really, really like this one. I used another one before that I thought I liked the most, but then I used this one and I like this one more than the other one, and I will show you the other one if I'll find it here. I supposed to have one more. Actually, I have a couple more sunscreens in here. I don't know where is the other one, but as when I'll find it, I will tell you about. Is the Suntegrity. Let's spread everything and see where is that one. And looks like that one escaped. This happens when you have too many. It might be here, I don't know. But anyway, if I will find that one, I will show you a picture with that product. Anyway, I don't see it here. But so far, between this one and the Suntegrity tinted sunscreen 5-in-1, this one is my favorite. The two of them are tinted sunscreens. This one has a matte finish with vitamin C, green tea, cranberry fruit, and pomegranate extracts. Works for rosacea and acne prone skin, for under and over makeup. I didn't use it over makeup because I don't really see how. But anyway, it blends very well and has a night tint, who looks very natural on my skin. And also, as SPF has an SPF of 30. I would like to buy this one in a full size. And I have no idea where the other one is. But anyway, the other one was the Suntegrity Tinted Sunscreen SPF 30. Comes in 4 shades, the other one. And it's a BB sunscreen that renews, hydrates, protects, primes, and covers the skin. You can blend it with your finger, a brush, or a sponge. Whatever. Where is that one? But between that one and this one, as I told you, I like more the MD Solar. Although the other one is great too. If I will find that one in a sale, I would buy that one. The formula is a little bit different for that one. That one is more like a mousse. This one is more like a cream. So another one that I have, and it's my my favorite, is the sunscreen. Is the Super Goop Ancien Sunscreen SPF 40. This one is my favorite at this point. I use this one, is the balm one. I use also the cream one, and works as well as this one. It's one of the very few sunscreens that doesn't leave a white cast, of course, because it's not white, it's a balm. But also it doesn't ball up with the creams that I used. So this one is with natural finish, oil free, invisible, lightweight, no fragrance, and SPF 40. I use many of these. I use a full size last year, and I will buy it in a full size for sure. Then I have 2 of the Kula, and I hope I have at least those. Then from Kula I have the classic sunscreen. I have the one in the cucumber one, and this one is the fresh mango. The sizes are different. Anyway, the two of them are No, the classic one is SPF 30, this one is SPF 50. This one, the cucumber one, it's UVA, UVB protection, 40 minutes water resistant. This one is nice as formula, but whatever moisturizer I use, this one was making everything boiling up. So I don't know why, because this one is in the same range with this one, is the same product, different as SPF and scent. This one I have no problem with. The fresh mango one, it work as a charm. I do like it. I use probably five or six different moisturizers to see how it works, and I have no problem with this one. Probably with 4 out of 5 moisturizer was boiling up like nothing else. So I know I have probably, if I look, I will look back in my skincare collection part 2, I will see which one I have, because I know I have three or four full sizes. So whatever it is, I will use it. As far I don't use a moisturizer, this might work well, but I usually put them on top of my moisturizer. So it was the sunscreen. Then I have Dr. Dennis Gross, and this one is the Alpha Beta Extra Strength Daily Peel. I use the deluxe sample with 3 of them. This one is 88 for the full size. I do recommend to buy the full size. The samples are way too expensive, but also there is a 61 with 150. The more you buy, the cheaper are the pads. Probably if you ask my empties, you know that those are my favorite peeling pads. I use them in and out for many years. I will always have them in my collection. This one is with glycolic acid and salicylic acid, and also I use the one that is the universal daily peel. The single difference that I saw on my skin, this one gives me a little bit of that tingling sensation, not in a bad way, doesn't irritate me, it's not too strong for me. This one is more mild, but they do work the same. It's a two-step peeling pad. You have step one and step two. You're supposed to massage step one after cleansing for a minute or until they get dry, and then wait 2 minutes and use step two. Same thing, massage it until it turns dry, the pad. The pads are quite a good size. I found them working very well, so I will keep always buying them. Then we have in here, you can use them daily AM or PM. It's quite expensive as price to use it daily, but I usually use them twice a week. Then we have the IT Cosmetics, and that one was a concealer. Is the Bye Bye Under Eye Illuminator. I'm not counting this product as an empty, as far it's not empty, but I don't know if I will finish it or not. It's a heavy duty concealer, at least for me. The color is in medium, light, medium, a little bit too light for my liking. I mixed this one with something else, has a full coverage. You need to find the right amount of product for your under eye, depending how many fine lines you have. I have a lot, and I'm not expecting for any concealer to look great. Everything that I'm using after hours is gonna sit on those fine lines and wrinkles. But anyway, it has a full coverage. I do like it. All you need is to find the right amount to not crease. It works well. I have minis like this from beauty boxes. I don't know if I will ever buy a full size, because they keep coming in beauty boxes in samples or deluxe samples or full sizes. But I do like it, and I do recommend it. And this one lightens, brightens, and conceal full coverage, radiant finish, waterproof. Then we have a serum, a Romanian brand, and this one is the Gerovital H3 Evolution Hyaluronic Acid Ampoules, 5% hyaluronic acid. I mentioned them because I saw them on Amazon. The price is very affordable, it's around $20. Comes in a glass vial, which you know I don't like, because I cut my face twice with another brand. But anyway, I do like the serum. I use it at night. I like the formula. It's brightening and hydrating. So I enjoyed this one, and I have the full size. I bought the full size when I was home last time. Then we have in here a Josie Maran product, and that one, let's see where I have that one. We have the Josie Maran Whipped Argan Oil Body Butter. Love the cream. I used it before, the scented ones. This one is the unscented one. About this one, comes in unscented sweet citrus, vanilla, apricot, and vanilla bean with nutrient-rich fatty acids and antioxidants to soften, smooth, and firm. It's not too heavy as a texture, blends very well, absorbs in no time, and keeps skin moisturized for hours and hours. I use this one at night, and next day around noon, my skin felt like I just put this one on. So I do recommend it. It's not on the affordable side, but worth to buy. Then we have a dry bar sample, and actually those are two samples. I have the Dry Bar Southern Belle Volume Boosting Conditioner and Shampoo. I was expecting this one to work very, very well. Actually, it was kind of disappointing. I didn't see much something special when I used those. I'm not judging a product by a sample. It did add some volume to my hair, but I would like to use it more before deciding if I like it or not. I don't see anything like softening or adding shine to my hair. Was just a little bit more volume, so I'm not so sure about this one. Comes in. Let's see if I have some details. I don't have the price for this one, but I will look online and let you know about the price. Then we have the Charlotte Tilbury Pillow Talk Diamonds. And boy, I love this one. I was planning to wear this one, but then I completely forgot. I put on something else. Is this one? I don't know if the camera will pick up the exact color on this one. It's such a beautiful product. This one comes in shimmer finish and metallic sheer pink with glitter shine, as with hyaluronic acid and emollient oils. It's 34 in a full size, but such a great product. Looks so nice on the lips. I thought the shimmer is gonna be like coming out. It's not. Looks really, really nice. So I enjoy the product. Probably I will put this one in a project pan because it's a beautiful product. And is the full size. Then we have a Drunk Elephant product, and this one is the Be Hydra Intensive Hydration Gel Quench and Illuminate with Pineapple Ceramide. I like the serum. About this one, it's a hydrating serum for dry combination and oily with pineapple ceramide, provitamin B5 and sodium hyaluronate. When you put this one first, it feels kind of sticky, but that soon absorbs, leaves the skin so soft and hydrated. I really enjoyed the sample. I would like to get more into Drunk Elephant products, but I don't know. I know they are quite expensive. I have a very small collection with deluxe samples, and one day I will go through them. Then we have the Butter London. And I don't have that sample with me. No, I don't have that sample with me. I will show you that one next time, and I'm not gonna count it as an empty. It's an illuminating product that I was planning to use as a primer. Anyway, we'll talk about that one next time. Then we have two samples from Laneige, and those are the. And if I'll find the other sample, the sunscreen, I will show it to you. Probably it fell from the basket because it has those holes on the side. Then we had the Laneige Cream Skin Milk Oil Cleanser. I have two samples. You're supposed to use them to remove makeup and cleanse your skin. About this one, it's a low pH 5.5 cleanser to remove makeup and leave skin soft. For all skin types, you're supposed to massage it on your face, then rinse it, remove the makeup, rinse it with water. I tried one sample like that with a full face of makeup, and I regret it because it doesn't work very well to remove makeup. Works much better as a second cleanser. So I do not recommend them to remove makeup, but as a second cleanser, if you like a light formula, this is a milk formula, it might, you might like it. I will personally not buy this one. I have other cleansers that I didn't try from Laneige, and to be honest, I don't know if this is not one of them. But if I have this one in a full size, you know that I'm buying tons of cleansers, and at this point I have no idea what I have. But anyway, if I have this one in a full size, I will use it as a morning cleanser or a second cleanser for night. Then we have the L'Occitane Dry Skin Foot Cream, and I have a couple samples. I will have more like this in my empties. As I told you, if I have more products, same samples, I'm not gonna put them in empties until I'll finish all of them. And I have three in here. This is the L'Occitane 50% Shea Dry Skin Foot Cream, my favorite foot cream for many, many years. The full size is $29. I have a full size, and probably after I'll finish the ones that I have open, I will go ahead and use the full size. I do like it. It's very moisturizing, works very well for dry feet, and also absorbs quickly, doesn't stain your sheets. I highly recommend. I do like it. I will buy it again. And then we have some products from Herborian, and we have some CC creams. I have those two samples, and one of them was in clear, the other one was a tinted one. I used the clear one first, and I really like the formula. I like to use this one alone. I like to use this one under makeup. If you use it alone, it's gonna leave your skin looking so healthy and glowy, with a natural glow, not that intense color. I don't know why they have so many bad reviews on the Sephora website, because I used this product a while ago and I remember loving it. And this sample confirms me again that I still like the product. I used the tinted one today earlier this morning, and my skin looks like I was spending 2 months on the beach. It's more like a tanning color for my skin, for my skin tone. Love, 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 love the formula, love how well it blends. As coverage, I would say the tinted one is somewhere to medium to full coverage, depending how your skin is. I have lots of red spots, but this one covers them. You need to be very close to my face to see through the tinted CC cream. I really, really like it. I bought one in the Ulta 21 days when it was in sale, and also if you watched my last Ulta free bags, it came a full size in one of the bags, and I cannot wait to go home and search wherever all the stuff to find them and see which one I have, the tinted or the clear one. But the two of them are working great, great, great. If I have only one of them, the tinted, I will buy the clear. If I have the clear, I will buy the tinted one. Lovely product, at least for me, and I really don't understand why it has so many bad reviews. And this one is for dullness. It's a dullness corrector for dull skin, light coverage. I would say for me was more than light, radiant finish, SPF 25, also with licorice extracts, centella asiatica, violet pigments, and to neutralize yellow and olive skin tone. I don't know about that, but I love how it looks on my skin. So the next product in here, it's a hair product, and this one is Living Proof Restore Perfecting Spray. It's for all hair types. Damage hair to dry and dry heat protection, increased shine, conditioning detangler. And what else about this one? You're supposed to apply this one on damp hair from roots to ends. I love the scent of this one, and I think it helps to detangle your hair. My hair usually needs a lot of pull and push to get through after I wash it. Not many times I'm combing my hair when it's wet, But I tried this product on damp hair and I really like it. Beside the scent, I like you supposed to, I usually apply it in strands and comb it and whatever. I do like the product. I have minis like this. This is a very tiny one. I don't know what I have in my collection. As I told you, I may have a full size from FabFitFun because I remember buying a lot of living proof products from FabFitFun and also from the Sephora favorites. So I may have this one. If not, I will look at some point to buy it as a detangler, which is actually the main point for the product. Then we have an oil that I told you about. This one is the Huara Candle Nut Perfume Oil. Smells divine. This one is the full size. It's $28. You can buy this one only from Birchbox. I will buy another one because I love the scent. I love to put this one on my wrist when I'm editing or doing paperwork. Lovely scent. I will have probably next time or in another review the body wash and the body cream in the same scent. But until then, this one is a fresh coconut scent. Then we have a Kiehl's product, and this one is powerful wrinkle reducing eye cream. Love, love, love this one to reduce wrinkles and fortify skin texture with copper PCA for moisture, calcium PCA for collagen, and caffeine for puffiness to use morning and night. I love this one. I love how is the formula for the product. I love how it blends under my eyes. It doesn't ball up if I use a serum. I like how my under eyes feels and looks after I'm using the product. I think it's a little adds a little bit of firmness, if I can say that. Smooths the skin, and I would like to buy this one in a full size. Highly recommend this one. I really like it. Then we have two perfume samples, and for those I will leave the notes on the screen. I have the Good Girl from Carolina Herrera. I love it. I would like this one in a full size, but I'm trying to stay away. I'm trying. I don't promise I will. This one is a warm floral. It's described as intoxicating. For me, it was long lasting. Lasted quite well on me, and I probably at some point I will buy the full size. And I'll also I will tell you the notes. It's more easy than typing. This one is with tuberose, jasmine, and tonka bean. Lovely scent. Then we have the Vivala Juicy. I have two samples also. For those, this one is the glaze one. As notes, frozen mandarin, pear, sorbet, jasmine petals, sumptuous vanilla, and milky sandalwood. Nice. Probably I will never look to buy the full size, but I like it. Then we have the Gucci Bloom, and I have a whole bunch of Gucci products. I have the Gucci Bloom, this one, and this one, and also I have the Bloom Acqua di Fiore, two of them. About the Gucci Bloom, the original one, as it's floral and as notes is has ragoon, creeper, not so sure if I'm saying that right, jasmine bud and tuberose. And for Acqua di Fiore, the notes are this one is fresh floral, which is this one. As notes, green galbanum, jasmine, cloves, basil, and sandalwood. Between the two of them, I do like the two of them, but between them, I like the Acqua di Fiore more than the original one. And let's see if we have something else. We have some hand creams in here. And those are from L'Occitane. And I have the L'Occitane Dry Skin Hand Cream, and you're gonna see many of those in my samples or my empties. I have a small basket with, and this is my favorite size for a hand cream. Anyway, I have three for dry skin. About this one, it's 20% shea butter. All of them absorbs quickly. They don't leave any greasy residue. I'm using them when I'm driving, whatever. During the day, whatever I'm doing absorbs well and doesn't leave any residue, not that greasy feeling. And also I have the this one is the Amande Precious Hands with almond milk and almond oil. Of course smells divine, as all the products from L'Occitane. And also I have the Harvest Honey Harvest with 20% shea butter for dry skin, with shea butter and organic spring honey. I felt like this one came in an advent calendar. I felt like this one was a little bit more rich as formula. I use it at night, but still the great as great as the other ones. They work very well. They are my favorite. The L'Occitane hand creams are my favorite for a long time, and I will always buy them. But for now I'm using those samples, and I think this is kind of all that I used in this, the last update. Now let's go ahead and pick up some new samples, and let's free this basket. I love this basket, this tray. I love it. Works so well for so many things. And now let's pick up the basket with the samples, and I will go again by category. And let's have first the one with body products, and let's pick some products. I don't know how many we'll take. This one is the Nest Grapefruit and Verbena, and Grapefruit and Verbena Fragrance Body Wipe. And the other one, Water Activating Cleansing Wipe. So we'll see about them. Then we have a tiny sample, and this one is the Exfoliate Easy Does It European Wax Center. Have no idea where I got this one. Then this one is Purely's Coconut Oil and Coffee Sugar Body Scrub. I know the product, that's why I'm smiling. Then let's see, we have in here a men perfume, and this one is Chanel Bleu de Chanel. I will spread this on Colin. Let's see what else we can take. And we have in here Pore Intensive Nourishing Soap, Handmade Kaolin. I don't know, we have a hand soap in here. And let's see, this one is another hand cream from L'Occitane, and this one is the Roses et Riens. I'm not saying that right for sure, but another one that it's lovely. And of course I don't have all the samples here that I used since the last update. You're gonna see more samples, and I will have the total number of samples and full sizes in my empties, which I will film probably in a day or two. If you wanna see more samples, watch my empties, because in that one I have all of them. Also I have samples in the advent calendars review, in the pendant kit project pen, and other projects. But usually the empties are having all of them. I mentioned the number, but probably I'm not gonna do the review for all of them, as far I review most of them in this video. And let's go with another sample, and this one is the L'Occitane Vervain Refreshing Cloth. So looks like we have couple body wipes, and that's kind of all for that category. Now let's go ahead and pick up the hair products. And first thing in here, it's Living Proof Perfect Hair Day 5-in-1 Styling Treatment, which I have in my bathroom in a small deluxe sample. Then we have Argan Gold Hair Pack, which is a Korean product. I will tell you more about this one next time. We have Sexy Hair Love Oil, Moisturizing Oil. And let's pick up one more. I still have one more product, so I will go with the foil. And this time we have the Kerastase and those for damage hair, kerastase resistance line, Vita cement. It's a shampoo and a mask. So we have those two, and I think it's more than plenty. Hair products are not quite the most used products for me. Now let's go ahead and pick up some skincare. And here is one that wanna be review. And this one is the Elemis, the Pro Collagen Marine Oil. We talk about this product in the Advent Calendars review. If you didn't watch that series, we're gonna talk about this one next time. Then we have another sample, and this one is the Sephora. We have two samples actually, some makeup remover, some wipes. Then let's pick up something else from here. And we have two of them. One of them is the Rice Water Bright Foaming Cleanser from the Face Shop. And this one is Jeju Volcanic Lava Anti-Dust Pore Cleaning Foam. And still from the Face Shop. I bought something from them, a cleansing oil, and they sent me those two samples. And now let's pick up something else. And we have a Sephora Caffeine Eye Mask, which I never used before, so that's great to try that one. Let's go deep in this. Oops. Let's try to find something else in here. And I will pick up this one. And this one is the Hey Honey Good Morning Facial Serum, which is this sample. So I think that's kind of enough as skincare. And now let's pick up some makeup. We're gonna review the makeup, but I'm not gonna hold them, as I told you in the intro of this video, I'm not gonna hold them until they are completely finished, because I might never finish them. I might not like them, or who knows how long it's gonna take me to finish those. And of course, everything is falling apart because it's the fullest one. So let's pick up this one. And this one is Wish Botanical Primer. Quite a good size in here. We have another one that fell. And this one is the Lorac from the Front of the Line Pro Eye Pencil in Black. And let's see. We have in here the Amazing Cosmetics. And as far as I know, this is a concealer. So is this one. And let's see. We have in here DHC Velvet Skin Coat Makeup Artist, which I believe it's a primer. And let's take one more. This one is the Super Fan Mascara, and I believe this one is from Smashbox. Yes, the Smashbox mascara, which also I never tried. And then let's take one more sample, and this one is Bare Minerals Gen Nude Patent Lip. And what's this one? Let's see if we have a shade. Let's open this one. It's a tiny one in here. I will tell you the shade next time. All it says here is Gen Nude. So I don't know much about them. I will try to find the shade and oops, and let you know next time about this product. So that's kind of all that we pick up for next time. Even if I'm not gonna use all of them, we're gonna review most of them in the next update. Let me know what are the samples that you tried lately and you love. If it's something that you recommend, probably, not probably, for sure, all of us will like to read in the comments down below. So that's kind of all for now. I will see you soon with another video. I will see you next month with the review for those products. Have fun, stay safe, bye-bye.